There are levels of breakthrough that you'll never reach until you're involved in prayer and fasting. Jesus said in Matthew 17, verse 21, "Howbeit this kind goes not out but by prayer and fasting." Now, we are living at a time in the gospel when the teaching, the doctrine of prayer and fasting has been diluted. And there are people out there saying that Jesus died on the cross and he finished the work, so it's not necessary to pray and fast. Nothing can be farther from the truth. We have examples in the Old Testament and in the New Testament where the Bible encourages us to pray and fast for breakthrough. Daniel prayed and fasted for 21 days so that the principality and power and the ruler of Persia can be destroyed. In the New Testament, we have examples, even after Jesus died and rose from the dead, of where the disciples prayed and fasted. In Acts chapter 14, we have an example of the apostles ordaining elders in every city. The Bible says in verse 23 that they prayed and fasted and laid their hands on them and commissioned them for the work of God. This is the New Testament. Paul, writing to the couples in 1 Corinthians chapter number 7, he tells them that you can pray and fast, but you need to agree for a season. This is in the New Testament. And the Bible says even Paul himself is giving his credentials, the things he has achieved in ministry. He says in fasting often, in famine often, in nakedness. And then he also mentions in fastings often. So there is power when we pray and fast. There are levels of breakthrough that you may never achieve this year until you get engaged in prayer and fasting. I encourage you, as we begin the year, commit yourself to pray, to fast, because there are breakthroughs that God has preordained for you, and He's waiting for you to take action and begin to pray and fast. God bless you, and may you have a blessed new year and prosperous breakthrough in your life.